He's covered by Rondo. Shoots off the screen. And that's a foul called on Andre Blatch. That is his first foul of the game.
Well, I love the fact that he's fighting hard on the boards, but you know, you got to be smart too. Over the back, that's an easy call there.
Well, that's simply the result of poor position under the glass. But at least you can't fault him for being passive. He was trying to be aggressive there.
Here's what Boston's going with right now. Jared Sullinger's checked in for Kelly Olynyk. Green comes in for Wallace. And Smart subbed in for Marcus Thornton. Let's go now to the sideline and catch up with Doris Burke. Hey, Doris.
Well, Kevin, DeMarcus Cousins signed by the Kings to a max contract extension in 2013. Coach Mike Malone said, quote, "We've made a huge commitment, not only to him as a player, but as a person." He added that Cousins' biggest jump will come from handling adversity and being comfortable when he's uncomfortable. Once he does that, it's scary how good he can be. Kevin?
A fiery disposition. If he can channel it, the sky's the limit. Thank you, Doris.
Well, starting last season, just about the only thing that didn't change for the Kings was the city they play in. Sacramento fought off a strong bid from a Seattle ownership group, and instead, a new group bought the teams and kept them in Sacramento.
Now, a timeout called by Boston. At this point of the game, always important to stay focused, and while the coach goes over the game plan, these players are getting a much-needed chance to rehydrate and refuel with Gatorade. Hey guys, we know the drill well, all three of us drinking the Gatorade too.
Yeah, no question. Right. I mean, Kevin, people have no idea the fatigue that can set in during a telecast. And so it's important for us to stay hydrated all game long.
Clark, you're always hydrated.
Yeah, I try to be, but it's usually with a combination of H2O and Gatorade.
I love Gatorade. Look at Steve, got the Gatorade shirt on.
Yeah, he's really immersed in the Gatorade. Yeah.
Gotta love it.
Brandon Bass is checked in for Boston. Bradley comes in for Rajon Rondo.
And you know, you look at the turnover for Sacramento last season, new ownership, a new GM, a new coach, extensive roster turnover as well. They might have needed name tags to identify each other. I like the fact that he led his teammate right to the ideal spot. You don't always throw it to your teammate. You throw it to where he needs to be.
Now here's Turner. Still getting warmed up offensively. No buckets yet in the game for him. Fires high post. Bass can't get it to go. And speaking of the new ownership group for the Kings, Shaquille O'Neal, last season signing on Steve as part of bringing some cachet.
Not to mention Hall of Famer Chris Mullin brought into the front office as an advisor. So the Kings adding experience and prestige to their team.
Okay, that's a two-pointer. The kick out to Collison. Drains the three-pointer. Collison's got his first 3 points of the game.
And they've set up countless buckets off assists. That's a huge part of what they've been doing here today.
A lot of dime dropping going on out there, Steve.
Poked loose. And now Sacramento on the break. Here's Gay. And he takes that one up and powers it through.
Boy, I love it. Active hands on the steal, active feet on the fast break.
And Clark Power on the dunk.
And guys, this is just too close of a game to be giving the ball up like that and then failing to get back in transition. Things have kind of gone south for him here in the quarter.
Outside Collison. Gay in the corner. Six to shoot. Off target from three-point range.
Not able to find it here in the second. He's off stride and off track just a bit after that one he had earlier.
Smart misses. Sacramento leading by five. Collison kicks to Cousins. And there's the feed to Gay. Screened by Cousins. Gay with it. Now guarded by Smart. Here's Gay. Gets the front of the rim and out.
He's going to play his way right onto the bench and out of the game if he continues to shoot it like he has so far in this quarter. Fellas, he just is struggling to get anything going. Right now, his shooting percentage in the quarter, 20%.
Evan Turner to start last season, a feature offensive player, Steve, for the rebuilding 76ers.
Oh, yeah, Andre Iguodala and Drew Holiday traded away in consecutive seasons. So Turner's numbers went up with the team struggling, but you know, he didn't seem very happy about the roster changes because, boy, they were losing night in and night out.
Celtics trail by three. They could use a big shot here to get this offense going.
Sure could, Kev. I mean, too many empty trips. They need some points.
Sacramento's gone 1-4 from three-point range in the second. Not a whole lot dropping out there for them. Over in the corner, Delfino. That falls. Great assist by Darren Collison. Collison's got his fifth assist in this one. Time called here. The Celtics decide to talk it over.
Sacramento was one of the teams in the West who really struggled against the Eastern Conference. And a lot of it had to do with their turnover.
Some changes for Boston. Green comes in for Turner. Rajon Rondo is subbed in for Smart.
As you said, I mean, the Kings were one of the few West teams that struggled against the East. 13 wins out of conference, which was second lowest in the West.
Kings leading now by three. Here's Collison. Misses off the left iron. Boston's gone 0-3 from beyond the arc to start the second quarter. Bradley kicks to Green. A floater. And the layup is good. Green's got six. As you mentioned, it was turnovers that really hurt the Kings against the East.
You know, they did some things well and played their game for stretches, but when you turn the ball over like the Kings did, you have to play every other facet of the game perfectly to stand a chance.
Now, here's Collison. He dishes it to Delfino. Pocket six. Here's Cousins. Let's it go from 14.
You just assume he's going to knock those down when he's as open as he was there.
Rondo kicks to Green. Back to Rondo. Passes it to Brandon. Feeds it to Bass. Puts it up from 15. Not enough on that one as it misses. The Kings leading. Cousins with a screen for Collison. Rudy Gay on the wing. That falls. Great assist by Darren Collison. 14 points for Gay. Sellinger is screen on Collison. Rondo passes to Sellinger. Here's Bass. Sacramento grabs the miss.
Obviously, they're evenly matched teams on the inside. The rebound numbers are very even.
Yeah, I've been impressed with just both teams' energy, just really working hard on the boards.
Collison dishes to Delfino. Back to Collison. From about 16, no good from Gay. Celtics trail by four. Bradley kicks to Sellinger. The drive by Rondo. Here's Bradley. Here's the three. The offensive rebound.
It just hasn't been a very good day for him, guys. They need him to start burying some of those.
Gay in the corner. And he comes off the screen to bury the jump shot. Now it's a six-point Kings lead.
A large part of what they've been able to do here is centered around his offense.
Rondo kicks to Sellinger. and stolen by Cousins. The shot, no good. The clock runs out, and we're heading to halftime. Kings lead by 6. And don't go away. After the break, we'll see you right back here for the start of the third quarter. And it's been a back-and-forth game so far with no ground given through the first half. Third quarter starting here now.
Boy, what a great game for Gate. 16 points, and he's hit the mark twice from three-point range as well.
Well, it's no secret. I mean, the more points he can come up with from out there, the better off they'll be offensively with their spacing.
Now, here's Collison. They lead by 6, their biggest margin. Second half underway. Here's who Mike Malone's got on the floor. Landry and Cousins patrol the paint. Carlos Delfino out there with Collison. And it's Gay in a small forward.
You know, one aspect of their play today that's really been tight and far superior is their passing.
I agree. I mean, if you look at the points, I mean, they're getting a lot of baskets off of assists. So the offense really clicking here.
Here is Collison after Rajon Rondo's bucket. Rondo against Collison. 6 on the shot clock. Here's Gay outside. That drops. Gay's got 19 points.
D there, guys, was pretty much non-existent. I mean, you can't leave a good shooter like that open.
Rondo kicks to Bradley. Good. And it's Rondo who picks up the assist. Rondo's got 3 assists in the game.
Look at the points in the paint, the inside game. It's been very one-sided here for a while now.
Well, the defense just hasn't been physical enough at the rim. I mean, 8 of their last 10 points have come from the paint.
And he gets it to go.
The D has gotten a little lax defending the three-point shot at that end.
Agreed, Clark. They've poured in 3 of the last 5 baskets on pretty open looks behind the arc.
The drive by Green.
Now that's finishing your work right there.
Powerful two-hand, Jim. You're right.
If he's got a few more of those in him, this lead will really start shrinking.
Ball's knocked loose. He gets stolen by Sullinger. The 9-foot shot. Second shot opportunity. And he was fouled on the way up. 2 free throws now for him.
Well, you allow them to get right to the rim like that. That's your only option.
Yeah, I think you got to foul them, and free throws are better than a layup.
That free throw missing.
Well, Jared Sullinger grew up with the game. His father was a demanding high school coach, and the word is that Jared was actually doing footwork drills at the age of 2, shooting regulation free throws by 3. You see how strong he is, and he's got a great IQ and skill for the game.
Cousins with a screen for Gay. Clock at 6. Can he keep it going? And Boston with the rebound. Sullinger's got rebound number 8 here tonight in the game.
Now, still a great start to the half after hitting their first 3 even before that miss. Well, that was good, strong D out there, and a very shaky decision taking that shot.
And Doris Burke has something for us. Hey, Doris.
Hi, Kevin. When former college coach Brad Stevens came in to coach the Boston Celtics, some worried that he'd have a tough time winning over headstrong point guard Rajon Rondo. But the 2 hit it off. Rondo said they become best friends, adding, "We talk every day. We laugh and joke. He has my full support. I'm behind him 100%. Kevin?
Rondo keeping an open mind and making himself accountable to Stevens' vision, Doris. Thanks. Back to Cousins. And so it looks like the Kings will retain possession here.